Hey guys, Footy Manager TV here, and welcome back to another episode of my journeyman career in FM 2014 with Club Bruges. The end of the season here today. You know, the previous episode I said it will be the last episode, but there's some very important like team meetings and all of that I want to show you. I feel as though it's very important. It's probably going to be a short episode because I just want to show you the roundup of the season, and everything will be pretty short. So apologies that I got it wrong, because I felt, yeah, it is important. I just didn't want to show the last match because I already won the league, so I felt it was just pointless. But we have an end-of-season team meeting here, and I've got some other things to go through, so I'll go this first. And let's see our expectations. I'm going to say passionately, congratulations on winning the title. It's a great achievement, and you all deserve a good break now. Make sure you come back fully rested and good condition, though, because I won't accept any less than winning it again next time around. But the second option is very interesting. I actually did this already, but I made a mistake. I thought it meant for my team to get prepared for the Champions League next season, but everyone got a bad result and saying you're too low expectations, because that's you're aiming to qualify for next season, like to come third or something, or second. It's been a long season. I hope you all have a good break, and you're going to need to come back fully refreshed, because I'm aiming to qualify for the Champions League next time around. What I thought that meant is for them to get ready for the Champions League next season. I did that, and all of my team got mad morale. So now I learned from that, and I'm going to say the first option, and it should get good reaction. See there. It's going to take a lot of hard work, and yep, that's better. Sometimes you have to do that, so that's the sort of reaction I'm asked. And no players, but that's better. And then the previous one I did, everyone was like red going down, so I definitely didn't want to know that. And yeah, so I reloaded it because I got confused what it meant. That's the thing. I thought it meant for my team to get ready for the Champions League because we qualified it. It should have said that, to be honest, because that's what we're going to be in next season. But I did want to show you some transfers I made. I know I said I probably won't make transfers for regen players, but that's for the big money. They will cost a lot. I mean, guys I can get for cheap will be very good for a couple reasons. Like this guy here, Javier Galindo, who has a 3.5-star potential ability, potential to be a star in this league, and we got him for free, zero, so you might as well. And the thing is, because I don't know exactly how long I'm going to be at this team, that's the main thing. So yeah, for that reason as well, because I could be here up to 5 seasons, just depends what I can do in Europe. And also, I want to, when I leave, I want to get these players in their profile as I'm in their favoured personnel. It doesn't say, this guy doesn't even have a favoured personnel right now, that's what I mean. And I want to get in that, so maybe I can get him to a team I move on to in the future, and he has me as a manager as his favourite personnel, and he will be willing to, might be interested to leave. I can talk to him and stuff, and he might want to leave. So that's another reason why I'll be doing that, and to get him for free is a decent player, taller type, even though he might not even play for me. It's free, so there's no like problem with that. There's no risk, really. And also Sander Koopman, who I feel is a guy who could break through the team, maybe as Gudjonsson gets a bit older, and if his quality is not good enough next season, this guy is definitely someone who can come in and do a job on loan in the second league. He's done a very solid performance, 3 goals, 2 assists, and just a solid all-round player, getting a 7.18 rating. Really, really good from him. Did the meeting and confidence review, you can see here. The board say, we are absolutely delighted with your performance at this club this season. The club's performance in competition entered this season was very good. The team's fantastic overall performance in the Belgium Cup has been a particular highlight. That's great. Additionally, the signings you made have been proven successful. The fans are happy with the signing of Marino Costanzo. I'm happy with him as well. Finally, player performances proved to be at a high level. The fans have been very pleased with Victor Vazquez's form this season, as I am as well, and I'm untouchable right now. That's perfect to have. I couldn't really do any better. Obviously, we couldn't win the Europa League in the first season. There was a team like Juventus and Fiorentina who we played against. Realistically, it would be unrealistic if I won. Like, you would think that's unrealistic if I won the Europa League. So, obviously, I'm not going to be in this season unless I come third in the group stage of the Champions League, which is still, it could be a possibility. You just got to see how the second season pans out. So, a scouting report here. Van der Boys. I think we have a player with that name, so I got confused there. But this guy is from Lokeren in this league. He is, I know, he doesn't look too fantastic. Like, he doesn't look better than what we already have. So I probably won't go for a signing for him, honestly. Like I said, he's not better than we already have. Yearly training summary. Some good improvements. And Matthew Ryan has improved just in his overall game. Obviously, he finished the season now, so he's probably dropping a little bit. This guy's got the biggest name ever. Valentinos Vlachos. What a name is that? And you can see he's increasing very well. He's done, at the start of the season, I didn't think he was technically good enough, but he proved he can play well. I'm not sure, why do you think he played so well? Is it his pace? Or, yeah, he just played really well. I thought he had poor technical attributes, and he's improved to a decent player. He looks decent. He looks better now, definitely. John Gastania, fantastic signing, 165k from Real Sociedad, and he moved up to a 1.6 million. If we sell him for some reason in the future, we can make profit, but I really like him playing that halfback role, defensive midfielder, because he can create and defend, and that's exactly what we need from that kind of role, and he does it perfectly. And also Dedric Boyata, who we signed in January for Man City, a good transfer, very good. We signed him for only 160k, bargain deal there, and he's just going to continue to grow, and he's from Belgium as well, so that's perfect. You need, those six homegrown players in the matchday squad, very important. Ter Derek's as well. It's realistic that he's improving because we gave him chances. And he's got good potential as well. Four-star potential ability. And he's a really quick player. You know, I've praised him before. He's got flair, pace, passing ability, and finishing ability. So he's got definitely a strong attribute, especially for a striker, the mental attributes that are important off the ball and anticipation. They're two of the better ones. And of course, composure. But that's to do with his actual finishing ability, but more so his movement, which is anticipation off the ball. That's the movement for strikers, important attributes, in my view anyway. So preseason lasts 5 weeks. I always like to do it 5 weeks. I'm not sure why I do that. I just feel it's not the least one, but it's not too big as well. So I just feel that's the best to do. I don't know what anyone else does. Drop in your comments, but I'm just going to simulate through because I have made some other offers. But this will still be a shortish video. It's just going to be hopefully finalizing another signing that I can show you. And the Pro League is still going on for the other stages, even though they're very difficult. I know people drop comments for it. I read it, but it still sounds very difficult. But I do. Yeah, I do. Oh, why? Club Brugge have announced their plans. Improve has been scrapped. Lack of funds. That's disappointing because when the season starts again, we're not going to be in the red. That's disappointing. That's just what happens every season. So it's going to be hard to improve the training and youth facilities because every season you go into the red at the end of the season, but then it gets back again at the start of the season. So that's very important it's very disappointing, I should say. And look here, in profit, look at that, 5 million profit. So we couldn't do better than that. I made profit throughout the season. So you can't really say my finances are in a bad state. I improved it by 5 million, you saw from that stat. So there's not much more I can do from that. So unfortunately, the facilities couldn't be improved because it was out of my control, the finances. Maybe we might look to in the future, but I probably won't. I'll just look to spend on better players. But also, there's something I want to do. I want to improve the coaches in the team. I feel like if I can get better defensive coaches, that may... Because that's not something that was in my head ever before. Like, I've never thought coaches make a huge difference into your performances, but maybe they do. Like, drop in your comments, how big a effect do you think coaches make in terms of your results? I thought they just help your players increase in their attributes. But yeah, leave your thoughts in terms of them helping you play better. I'll definitely love to see your thoughts on that, because that will influence my decision on who to really sign and how to set up my backroom staff. That's definitely something I'll take into account. So again, I'm just simulating because I have another free transfer, hopefully, or not free transfer, another regen transfer, hopefully, to accept a deal. So it should be on the next update, because you see here, there's nothing too important. There's just all this manager interest and, nothing really too important. That's what you see here. One day Ramos, you see all this. So, when there's all these manager stuff, do you want me to do anything or just wait till I get offers for teams or whatever? Like, don't worry about it for now. Okay, this is the final one I wanted to get. This guy here, what's his name? Miguel Abreu, Portuguese young winger, 16-year-old. If you go to his information, he could be the next Vitor Pereira. He shoots from distance. He can play some positions. Interesting, he can play right back, so he could be that like wing back, which would be very good, and play on the right wing side. He shoots from distance. He got some nice attributes for a 16-year-old and still fairly cheap, as I said. A bit of pace in that. Mental attributes decent. Technique is 16 already. And you can see his report is 5-star. And to get him for that cheap, 165k. That's a pretty good deal. So he's going to, might be a guy you see in the future. And looking at those attributes, he could definitely make an impact in the league this season because, you know, I played similar players, to be honest, this season, a similar level. So it'll be very interesting to see how he comes up into the rest of the first team players, but we'll just see how it pans out. Maybe when he turns 18 or 19, a couple of seasons, it really depends my situation at Club Rouge. But that's it for now. Hopefully you like the regen signings I make. As I said, they're fairly cheap, so they're not going to be the major signings. The major signings are going to be what I update you next in the first episode of the second season, where I will be, yeah, obviously starting the second season. I'll give you an update of every transfer I made. I won't be doing that in videos because it's a lot of, I just like to think. I don't like to talk, like commentate and stuff like I am now. I just like to sit back and make my signings the way I like to do them through different methods. Like I sit down for like an hour or so to work it out. So it'll be too long for a video, definitely. And I don't like to talk. I just like to think in my head, put some music on and like that. Enjoy playing. Sometimes I just like to do that. So, yeah, hopefully you enjoyed it. Drop a like if you did. Drop a like if you want the next season very, very soon as well. And I'll see you guys next time.